Before the video starts, I just want to inform you that you may skip to different parts of the video that interest you using the timestamps in the description. So, you think you got the basics down of Rust to a science? You're wondering what your skill level is from 0 to H June, but you haven't gotten rating yet? Welcome to the only rating tutorial you'll ever need. Not this shit. Let's get started. There are many different methods to rating. The first is to figure out which one you will be using. You may choose depending on what you have or don't have. If you're low on scraps and cannot afford to learn certain blueprints, then you may want to choose depending on what's available to you at that moment. You can raid with satchels, explosive ammo, rockets, and or C4. The fastest route to raiding is with satchels. It is the only way of raiding without having a tier 3 workbench. I highly recommend getting to tier 3 and skipping satchels to save that precious scrap and learn better raiding blueprints. Satchels make a lot of noise, are unreliable, and are mating calls to letting people know you are using satchels and probably undergeared. The only time I can recommend using satchels is if you get access to them incredibly early and want to evict some neighbors before they build up too much. As soon as a couple hours pass into a wipe, in most cases, it's probably not even worth learning them anymore. Note that this is personal preference. If you're a slightly larger group, you may be comfortable with satchel raiding, and may welcome the additional challenge of having players culminate to your area. To raid with satchels, you'll need a tier 2 workbench, 250 scraps for the satchel, and 75 scraps for the bean can grenade. Next, we have explosive ammo. Most of the time, explosive ammo is the cheapest route. Not only that, but using a silencer along with either your semi-automatic rifle or assault rifle will make your raid completely silent, making this a great choice for solo raiding. Explosive ammo is great for splash damage. When using it, make sure you get the most out of it by splashing multiple walls or doors. You'll still need to reload your gun, so be very careful when raiding solo not to get jumped on while reloading. If there's multiple players firing explosive ammo, don't start firing all in sync to find yourselves all reloading at the same time. The downsides of firing explosive ammo is that it's slow, breaks guns, and you can easily find yourself missing a few bullets to finish a wall because of a miscalculation or a few misfires. Not only that, but crafting a large amount of explosive ammo takes an absurd amount of time. 10 stacks of explosive ammo takes 64 minutes of crafting, and that's not counting the time it takes to craft gunpowder. To raid with explosive ammo, you'll need a tier 3 workbench, 250 scraps for the semi-automatic rifle, or 750 for the assault rifle, 250 scraps for the explosive ammo, and 75 scraps for the silencer. Now let's talk about C4. You don't see C4 as often, simply because its cost to damage ratio in terms of gunpowder or sulfur is most of the time higher than other methods and doesn't splash. A good example of this is a metal wall. Destroying one using C4 would cost 8,800 sulfur in total, whereas explosive ammo is about 10,000 and rockets 11,200. The C4 would only damage one wall, whereas the other two could splash multiples, therefore getting a much better cost to damage ratio on rockets or explosive ammo. Don't underestimate the power of C4 though. C4 can blow through an armored wall in a mere 20 seconds, but rockets take 1 minute 25 seconds, and it takes explosive ammo 3 minutes and 40 seconds if you use the assault rifle. And that's not counting the damage you do to your guns. To raid with C4, you'll need a tier 3 workbench, 750 scraps to learn C4, and another 750 scraps to learn explosive. And lastly, rockets are considered meta for most players. It's fast and will completely melt anything in its path, players included. Bigger groups and advanced players will farm and stack up dozens of them and will mow down base of their opponents within mere minutes. Not only are rockets amazingly powerful, they are an absolute blast to use. There aren't many downsides to them, but here are a few. You have to be careful when running around. If someone runs in front of you while a rocket goes off, it will explode on the intruding player and will kill anyone in the vicinity. This can quickly lead your raid to fail and gives the opposing players a much more solid chance at defending. Secondly, reloading takes a few seconds. So if you're solo or duo, you have to be extremely careful. Experienced players know this, and they may push you as soon as you fire your rocket. Last one is obvious, but should still be mentioned. Cost. You need at least one rocket launcher, which are 50 high quality metal and 6 pipes each. Crafting one isn't too bad, but if something happens and you lose it, that'll put a complete stop to your raid and give defenders the chance to defend and repair completely. It's a good idea to bring extras, or at least have a backup if you lose it. Parade with rockets, you'll need a tier 3 workbench, 750 scraps for explosive, 250 scraps for rocket, and 750 scraps for the rocket launcher. Note that you're certainly not locked into using one rating material. You're welcome to use a combination of all of them if your blueprints allow it, and I encourage doing so to get the cheapest or fastest combinations to raid a base. Here's a quick example. A sheet metal door can be destroyed using two rockets for 2,800 sulfur, a C4 for 2,200, four satchels for 1920 sulfur, or 64 explosive ammo for 1600 sulfur. So ideally, explosive ammo would be the way to go, but as I've explained, it can be slow. So if I use a single rocket and another player shoots 8 explosive rounds at the same time, you get a much faster result with the same amount of sulfur used as the explosive ammo option, which is 1600 sulfur. There's a lot of different combinations, and this video could go on for hours, so I highly encourage players to visit rustlabs.com. It has all the information you can think of when it comes to damage and cost of different items. If you're wondering where you can find all you need for raiding, you can find them in different crates in the game, anywhere from a toolbox to elite and timed crates. The best way of knowing exactly what drops from what and what the drop rates are, Rust Labs will be your best friend. Okay, maybe you're ready to raid and your trigger finger is hella itchy. So before you head out, here are a few tips you don't want to skip over. Study your target. Don't chew on something that's too big for you. Try raiding something smaller for your first couple raids. If you think you might not have enough, then you most likely don't. Always make more than you need. When raiding, it's always better to have more than not enough. Make a raid base. There's nothing worse than going out with a ton of rockets and C4 and just losing everything instantly to another player. If you're solo, make it 1x2. If you're a group, make it a 3-story 2x2 with windows to roof camp any unwanted company. Make sure you put metal embrasures so you don't give anyone easy access to your raid base. And don't be an idiot by putting loot boxes next to your windows. Players can and will loot them. Next is gear. Bring extra gear sets, foods, medical syringes, and etc. If you die and can't get back to your body, respawn in the raid base, re-gear, head back out as fast as you can. If you're unsure if your body is accessible or your loot has been taken, it's wise to take some gear with you anyway. If someone is still looting your body, you'll be able to shoot the player and recover what belongs to you. Communication. Comms are important when it comes to raiding. The first couple times it may get hectic, so get ready for it. Designate a raid leader if you need to, and have that person make callouts. Last but not least, keep your cool.